Want to take a look at the Vic's stomach contents?
Most people don't usually invite me to participate in the process.
Most people are intimidated by your job.
Mac tell you to do this, just like him to throw a curveball.
No, he didn't. But I just thought you might want to see what I was looking at.
So you know Mac? From a long time ago. Actually, we both applied for the job he has now. The crystals look like cocoa butter seeds caused when chocolate is agitated. Helps to refine high-end chocolate.
I didn't realize you could major in chocolate forensics. Wouldn't that be great?
No, I've seen those kind of crystals before. My specialization at the Jersey Crime Lab is microscopy, but the yellow substance, any ideas?
Alkaline extraction indicates some kind of plant material. Now, I'm running a morphological search right now, and it is Ternera aphrodisiaca from Central America, otherwise known as Damiana.
Any psychoactive properties?
Let's see. Damiana can be smoked, producing effects similar to cannabis sativa. It's used in herbal tea to promote lucid dreaming, and it's added to tequila to enhance lovemaking.
I am all for a good margarita.
I'm with you on that.
However, this sounds more like a drug.
Maybe the killer used it to subdue the Vic before he strangled her.
But nothing's ever perfect with you, Quinn.
Well, Detectives Messer and Monroe, they're obviously a little more than just co-workers.
I don't get involved in my team's personal lives.
Mac, I'm just giving you a heads up. As a result of what was obviously a personal exchange between Monroe and Messer, Monroe got distracted and left her evidence out, unattended. We can all try and compartmentalize, but nobody can help the fact that sometimes life gets in the way, and when things get messy, mistakes are made. And I believe I'm quoting you on that one.